Broadcast is now starting. All attendees are in listen-only mode.
Welcome to the 2019 Service Unit Product Chair Fall Product Program Training for Service Unit Volunteers. This is a supplemental training just for Service Unit Product Chairs, going over the specific roles and responsibilities of this position and the tools and resources we have available for you. If you have not already, we strongly encourage all SUPCs to attend the live webinar or watch a recorded version of the Fall Product Program Training for Volunteers to familiarize yourself with the program and any new features this year. Links to register and or view the recording of the training is on the Fall Product Program page of the bridge. My name is Samantha Digwin, the Assistant Director of Product Program. Also on the team is Lindsay Russell, the Director of Product Program. Today, we are going to go through what it means to be a Service Unit Product Chair and what your roles and responsibilities are, such as securing a delivery station and assisting with product and reward deliveries. We'll also show you how to navigate UNIFY, the online management system, getting started, and the resources we have available for you. As the Service Unit Product Chair, or SUPC, you help promote and coordinate the fall program and or cookie programs within your local service unit. You are the local point of contact for Troops and Juliets as another level of support. Troops and Juliets may come to you with questions about the program in general or the online management system, UNIFY. As the SUPC, you will also help with receiving and distributing products and rewards at the end of the fall program. As an SUPC, you are there to help support Troops and Juliets in your service unit. To fully understand what a troop should know and may potentially need help with, you should either attend a live fall product program training for troop volunteers or watch a recorded version found on the bridge. Once you have gone through the troop training, you can then be a mentor to troop product managers, helping answer questions and finding resources they may need. You will also support Juliets and their families. Juliets are girls who are participating individually, either because they do not have a troop or their troop decided not to participate in the fall program. Whatever the reason, as the SUPC, you will need to support them as the local point of contact. Most Juliet parents and guardians will opt to become registered and manage the fall program for their daughter directly, just like a TPM. If they opt to do this, they will do all of the product and reward entering in UNIFY themselves. If Juliet parents opt to not manage the program directly or need extra support, it is your role to facilitate order collection and enter in product and reward orders in UNIFY, just like a TPM does for girls in their troop. We will notify you directly of any Juliet families that request assistance managing the program. In the event that they do, it is your responsibility to act as a TPM for them. One way to share the benefits of participating in the fall program is by scheduling a fun kickoff for troops, Juliets, and families in your service unit. You can tell them all about the great rewards, and you can even request samples of nuts and candy from your Girl Scouts of Greater Iowa Leadership Center near you. Service units will receive fall program materials shipped to them in September. We have created the Service Unit Product Chair checklist that goes over information directly related to your role. Much of what we covered in today's training can be found in the SUPC checklist. Service units will also receive a feature highlights document sharing what's new this year. Service units will also receive the Fall Product Program Kit, a go-to resource for TPMs. This document covers topics such as the kickoff meeting agenda, how girls and families sell, girl and troop rewards, collecting money and paying for product, wrapping up the fall program, product delivery, and important dates and resources. SUPCs should familiarize themselves with this document to better support their troops. Along with mentoring troops, you will also need to support Juliet's and their families. So you will also receive a copy of the Juliet letter. This is a supplemental piece for Juliet's, highlighting the differences between troop and Juliet participation. Another resource we have put together is a quick start guide for girls who want to participate in the fall program, but just online. Finally, in your materials, you will also receive a copy of the Nut Order card. Outside of supporting troops and Juliet's, one of the most important responsibilities as Service Unit Product Chair is securing a location to accept all the nut and candy orders that will be delivered to your service unit. This delivery will occur between November 8th and 12th. In early November, you will receive a phone call from our delivery partner with your exact delivery date and estimated time frame. While we cannot guarantee any specific dates or times, if your location does have restricted availability, please note this in UNIFY under Delivery Station Details. When determining the delivery station, you will need to take into consideration the size of your service unit and/or the historical size of product deliveries. If you are unsure, we can provide the historical data for you. Another thing to consider is the accessibility of your delivery station. Most deliveries will be on a straight truck, and the product could be on pallets. So keep in mind the ease of trucks being able to get to a delivery station, especially if it's on a gravel road or residential area. Finally, consider the availability of the delivery station. Things happen, like weather, so when considering a location, consider the availability for you to accept deliveries at that location. Delivery stations will need to be entered into UNIFY by October 11th. We'll go over how to do this in UNIFY shortly. All SUPCs who have this information in UNIFY by that date will receive a free Girl Scout stocking cap. For the day of delivery, you will need to print and bring along with you two reports from UNIFY. One copy of the S1 Service Unit Nut Candy and Mags report, and two copies of the T2 Troop Order Nuts Candy Mags and More report. You will also want to bring pens, highlighters, and clipboards, making signing orders quick and easy. Also, plan to arrive at least 20 minutes before your scheduled delivery time. When delivery day comes and product arrives, be sure to count all the product with the delivery partner using the delivery ticket provided. Cross-reference the delivery ticket with the S1 report from UNIFY. Note any damages or shortages before the delivery partner leaves. If a case is damaged on the outside, open it up and check each item for damages. If a damage or shortage is noticed after the delivery partner leaves, contact Girl Scouts of Greater Iowa the next business day to ensure replacement. Once you have accepted the delivery from the delivery partner, noted any shortages or damages to them, you can then begin sorting orders by troops and Juliet's using the T2 Troop Order Nuts, Candy, Mags, and More report from UNIFY. Always sort all items before letting any troops or Juliet's take product to ensure everything is accounted for before pickup. Once troops and Juliet's come and pick up, make sure each of you counts the items twice together, ensuring you both agree on the counts. If a trooper is receiving a full case, open the case together and ensure that all product is there. Once you both agree on the counts, have the troop sign for the product on both copies of the T2 Troop Order Nuts, Candy, Mags, and More report. You should also sign this report. Since you printed two copies, you will keep one for your records and the troop will keep the other. Reward delivery is similar to product delivery. Unlike the product delivery, rewards can be shipped to a different location, like your home. Rewards are shipped via UPS or FedEx, so the only requirement for your location is that it cannot be a P.O. box. Before the reward delivery, you will need to print two copies of the T2 Troop Order Rewards Report from UNIFY. Once rewards are delivered to you, you should count the items and compare them with the packing slip provided inside the shipment. Report any missing or damaged items by calling the 800 number listed on the packing slip. Once you have counted the rewards and confirmed that they match with what is on the packing slip, you will need to sort the rewards by Troop and Juliet using the T2 Troop Order Reward Report from UNIFY. Just like with product, be sure to sort all of the rewards before letting Troops or Juliets pick up. Again, you will count the rewards twice with the Troop or Juliet, and then each party will need to sign both copies of the T2 Troop Order Rewards Report, each keeping a copy as a receipt. Please note that due to the nature of the high-level rewards, such as the Kindle, Bionic Bird, and Converse shoes, these will not be included in reward delivery. Girl Scouts of Greater Iowa will coordinate the delivery or fulfillment of these rewards directly with the girl and her family. Now that we have gone over some of the program highlights, we want to talk about the online management system for the fall program called UNIFY. UNIFY is used by service unit and troop volunteers and girls with their parents and guardians. UNIFY registration emails have started being emailed to all registered service unit product chairs who have filled out their agreement. Registration emails will come from the email address girlscout-sales@qspgao.com. Be sure to check your spam, junk, or promotions folders. Please allow up to a week from the time you submit your SUPC agreement to receive your UNIFY login. Volunteers who have multiple roles, like SUPC and TPM, or are the TPM for more than one troop, will have just one login to easily switch between roles or troops. We'll walk through UNIFY next, but SUPCs will use UNIFY to enter in your delivery station for product, adding any notes as needed, download the reports needed for product and reward delivery, and enter in product and reward orders for Juliets who have asked you to act as their TPM, or troops who may be seeking additional support from you. Now, let's walk through UNIFY. When you first log into UNIFY as a service unit user, the default screen will be the Service Unit Dashboard Rosters page. From here, you can navigate to the Troop Rosters by clicking on the Troop tab. By clicking on the Troop, you will see all Troop users that have been added for that Troop. If you see a Troop that starts with 99, followed by your Service Unit number, this is a Juliet. If you see there is a troop user for that Juliet troop that is not you, then that is the parent or guardian who has registered and is managing the UNIFY system for their daughter, just like a troop product manager does for their troop. If a parent or guardian of a Juliet is not managing UNIFY, we would have emailed you separately letting you know this and set you up as a troop user for that Juliet. You can also navigate to girl rosters by clicking on the girl tab. You can then search by troop or girl name. To navigate to other parts of the system, you will use the hamburger menu to the left of the screen. From there, you will see a drop-down menu where it will let you do things like see my info, where you can edit your contact information, select a previous campaign if you would like to see previous data for your service unit, go to the various dashboard tools and view reports. For now, we're going to look at the dashboard tools as that is where you'll more likely be spending most of your time in UNIFY. The first item listed on the dashboard tools is delivery. By clicking on delivery, you'll be redirected to the service unit dashboard delivery page. From there, you will need to add or edit your delivery station for the nut and candy delivery that will occur November 8th through 12th. To do this, click on the pencil and a pop-up window will open where you can edit your delivery station address, contact phone number, and enter in delivery station details as needed. Please note, you will not be able to edit the delivery date or delivery time frame. However, by providing us with dates or times that do or do not work, that will help the delivery agent with scheduling. Once updates have been made, click Save. On the service unit delivery page, you will also be able to view, print, or email the delivery tickets for nut and candy and rewards for a troop or girl once orders are submitted. You will also use UNIFY to download reports by going to the menu and selecting Reports. This is where you can download the S1 and T2 reports for product and reward delivery and pickup. Another feature in UNIFY is the ability to switch roles. If you are an SUPC and TPM, or perhaps a parent or guardian of a Girl Scout, you can easily switch between each dashboard. To do so, go to the menu and select Switch Role. To switch between dashboards, click on the one that you need to go to. Once you have your UNIFY login, we strongly suggest you look around and become familiar with the system. Now that you've learned more about the fall program and your roles and responsibilities as SUPCs, let's talk about what to do now. To ensure you have a successful start to the fall program, be sure you have done or are working towards the following. Fill out your Service Unit Product Chair Agreement. This is how we will know to get you an UNIFY login. Next, secure a delivery station for product delivery. Remember, you will receive a Girl Scout stocking cap by entering this in UNIFY by October 11th. We have lots of resources and materials ready for you to help you have a great fall program. Bookmark the fall program page of The Bridge. The website is gsgibridge.com/fall program. Another great resource is our weekly shout out newsletter. It is sent every Thursday at 6 p.m. If you are not receiving these, contact us and we will get you signed up. Lastly, get excited and have fun. This brings us to the conclusion of the Service Unit Product Chair Fall Program Training. Thank you for watching. If you have not attended the live webinar or watched a recording of the 2019 Fall Product Program for Troop Volunteers Training, links can be found on The Bridge. Thank you for watching, and as always, feel free to call or email us with any questions.